Hi fellows, in my today's tutorial video I'd like to show you how to use a PSNX data logger to record all changes in your application. Okay, let's open the PSNX Engine application. It's quite small. I have only one PLC inside, AXCF2152, with an XLAN module, digital in, digital out, and a very small application. Okay, let's open the task configuration of the application. It's quite simple. I'm using ESM1 and ESM2. On the second ESM, I have a generator for some values. So on the first one, I'm just listening on those values. I'll open all the port list. On the left side, you can see the generator values, the OPC UI word, string, and integer. And on the right side, the listening and the event task. On the top of the list, you have on the left side the digital ins of the XLAN local bus modules, which are also listening in the event task. And in different of the peer applications, I'm now listening only on the changes. Okay, have a look inside and let's go online to the PLC, how the whole thing works. Download the application. Now we go directly online. You can see that the values are changing constantly. The string changes every few seconds. And when I play now a bit around with my local digital inputs, you can see also here that the values are changing constantly. So far so good, and let's go now to the configuration of the data logger itself. Beginning with PSNX Engineer 2020.6, it will be possible to configure the data logger directly in the tool. Well, for all previous versions, you have to do it with a configuration file, and how this works, I will show you now. So, switch from PSNX Engineer and open WinSCP to get access directly to the PLC itself. Configure the connection details with IP address. And your username and password. Then connect and go ahead. Well, you can find the configuration files in the project folder. If they are not already there, just copy the folder given from the example on GitHub. On the folder, there's a data logger configuration. Open it, for example, with Notepad++. And here we go. Well, the most of the keys are, I guess, quite already familiar, so we can leave them behind. The most important one is the stored changes only flag, which is now changed to true. As soon as this flag is changed, or if this key is inserted in the configuration file, the data logger will only record changes of the configured variables. And here we can see our variables where I'm listening to. This is a digital in. And the two above are coming from the generator program. I changed also the time format to ISO 8601. This is a benefit that when you open later on the database, you can see a human readable data format, which is quite handy also for recording purposes. And also the wide interval to wide the values then on the SD card. Okay, store all changes. And copy the folder to the PLC in the directory projects. Well, go back now to PSNX Engineer, open the cockpit. And restart the PLC that the settings are getting active. Okay, when the PLC is rebooted, we can connect once again with the PLC. Open the debug view and check the state of the variables. Okay, here are the variables. The generator is updating, of course, constantly. And when I play around with the digital inputs, the values are changing. Go back to WinSCP and have a look what the data logger itself is doing. just perform a refresh on the database we are created, as you can see. When we play now a little bit more around with the digital inputs, true, false, and so on, blah, 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 then also the data logger is updating constantly. Okay, perfect. So grab now the database and copy it, for example, to your documents folder, wherever else you need it. Open a database SQLite browser like this one, DB browser for SQLite, it's free. Open the database. Great. Browse the table. Now you can see the values of the database with a clear timestamp and also only the changes of the variables. Yeah, here they are. Great. So you can see the string values which were changed, false, true, false, and also the changes which I triggered manually of the digital in. Quite useful is also a small little feature that on every variable also a change count value is added. So you can see right away how often a variable changed or how many changed events. Yeah, for example, for the digital in, you see all changes, 0, 1, 0, 1, blah, blah, blah. And then on the right side, the change count, which is incrementing constantly with every change. Quite handy. So for the diagnostics, you can use the notification server, which informs also to major events. But you can also dig really deep on the PLC with the output.log file. I'll show you where it's located. Once again, we are using WinSCP. Go to the logs folder. Open the output log file. Well, scroll to the button for the latest entries, and now you can change for the key data logger. Search up. Well, yeah, here you can see that the service has started. Perfectly fine. But also diagnostics could be shown here. For example, this variable were obviously previously not available, so you get a clear message, no such variable. Okay, close this log file, and then I would say enjoy the data logger. Leave me a note, leave me a feedback, and see you next time in my next tutorial video. Bye bye.